There was a little girl who was about 7 years old. She loved dolls, like the Barbie dolls. She loved the dolls and had collected many at home. Her room was full of dolls. One day she came to shopping mall with her mom and saw a new Barbie doll, which she wanted to have. She grabbed it and didn't let it go. She said to her mom, "Mom, please buy this one for me. This is the last one I ask you. I'm not going to ask you anymore, and I'm not going to complain for anything forever," she promised to her. Then she could get the Barbie doll. 15 years later, the little girl married, but a tragedy happened to her. Her husband died just 6 months after her marriage, and she had to raise her child by herself. It was hard, and eventually she lost her job. But through all those things, she never complained, because she remembered what she promised to her mom when she was young. She never complained. What a beautiful story is it? Have you seen any child acting like this little girl? No, this cannot be true. There is no such a girl. I'm sure she complained again next morning. That's who we are, right? I mean, in our sinful nature, we tend to forget what we have and we complain about what we don't have. In our sinful nature, we don't normally give thanks to anyone for anything. That's who we are. Today is Thanksgiving Sunday. We're trying to learn about Thanksgiving. But why? Why do we need to give thanks? Is it required? Is it necessary for our salvation? Or it is just about our attitude to have a better relationship? What does the Bible say about Thanksgiving? Paul explains about Thanksgiving in Romans chapter 1, verse 21. It says, "Although they knew God, they neither glorified Him as God, nor gave thanks to Him. But their thoughts became futile, and their hearts were darkened." The Israelites heard about God. They knew God, but they failed to do two things. They didn't glorify Him, and they didn't give thanks to God. Instead, they became more evil. This verse implies that not giving thanks to God is a sin, just like not glorifying Him. Without thanksgiving, they're not glorifying God. It is as much as serious than glorifying Him. They knew God, but they failed to give thanks to God. Let's look at another instance, another reference. Paul explains our sins in 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verses 7 through 10. He used the Greek grammar, and he emphasized more as he speaks by putting the conjunction and the adverb, negative adverb, in front of each sentence. He emphasized more as he speaks. In verse 7, he says, "Do not be idolaters." In verse 8, "We should not commit sexual immorality." When that verse 8, "Surely we should not test the Lord," he's kind of emphasizing the negative. Then in verse 10, "Do not ever grumble, as some of them did." the Israelite who had experienced all the miracles during the Exodus, they began to complain to God for water and food. Because of their grumbling, they couldn't enter the promised land. Grumbling, complaining, or not giving thanks is not just any sin, but it is more severe, more serious, or at least as serious as sexual immorality or testing the Lord. Do you see how serious, how important to give thanks to the Lord? But again, in our human nature, we're not willing to give thanks to the Lord. We don't know even what we need to thank for. David explains in our this morning in Psalm 103 what we need to thank for. He says in verses 1 and 2, "Praise the Lord, all my soul, all my inmost being. Praise his holy name. Praise the Lord, all my soul, and forget not all his benefits." It is an invitation for each and everyone to praise the holy name, Yahweh. All my soul, all my inmost being, praise his name, Yahweh, for the benefit received. The word to praise has another main meaning, which is to bless. This word, particularly this word, is used only for God. When God is the subject, it is to bless. God blesses his people. When God is the object, it is to praise. We praise God. And the benefit of blessings God has given to us. We praise God for the benefit God has blessed us. Do you see the relationship? We praise God for the benefit God has blessed us. That I don't think David used by accident this word. There is a relationship, praising and benefit and blessings. Praising is remembering all the blessings God has given to us. Giving thanks, praising is giving thanks for the benefit God has blessed us. Praise the Lord, all my soul, all my inmost being. Praise the Lord for the benefit, for the blessings he has given to us. Because of the blessings he has given to us, we give thanks to him. We praise him. Then David explains what the benefits are in verses 3 through 5. And those are what we need to thank for. First, we need to thank for his forgiveness of our sins. The Bible says we are all sinners. No matter how well we dress, no matter how much knowledge we have, or how successful we are all sinners. You are sinners. I'm sorry, but you are sinners. And I am a sinner too. There is no one righteous, not even one, in this world. If God punishes us according to our sin, we are already dead. Maybe probably more than 100,000 times, we are already dead. But he hasn't punished with our sins. Instead, God punished Jesus Christ, his one and only Son, so that we could be forgiven of our sins. Why is forgiveness necessary? Because without forgiveness, we are not righteous to go to heaven. We are heading to eternal hell. That's why Jesus says often in the first place in the gospel, your sins are forgiven. Because without forgiveness, there is no salvation. God can save us, actually he does, even before we repent our sins. But it is only when we realize our sins, that's the time we turn to God and give thanks to him. Without realizing our sins, we don't know even we need forgiveness. We don't know even we are forgiven. And our eventually and consequently, we don't give thanks to God. So the more we realize our sinfulness, the more we will give thanks to God. We give thanks to God. Another thing we need to thank for is everything we have in our daily lives. God, verse 3, the Lord heals your disease and redeems your life from the pit and crowns you with compassion and love and satisfies you with good things. These are all things we are seeking. The Lord heals our physical illness. He redeems or he recovers us from the bad environment, bad circumstances. And he is taking care of our spirit and minds. And he provides what we need. Isn't this what we seek and pray every day in our lives? Yes, the Lord blesses us every day in our lives. We may be still sick and the lack of some things, but we have what we need. Look at yourself and you know that you are blessed. If you woke up this morning more health than you need, you are more blessed than 6 million people were not going to survive in this week. If you have never experienced the danger of battle or loneliness of imprisonment, you are ahead of 500 million people. If you came to church without fear of harassment, torture, or arrest, or death, you are ahead of 3 billion people. If you have food in the refrigerator and clothes on your back, a roof overhead, and a place to sleep, you are richer than 75% of this world. If we have money in your wallet, I don't know how much, any money in your wallet, if we have some chain in a dish someplace, you are among top 8% of world's wealthy. See, you are rich indeed. We are all rich. Besides these material blessings, we know that God is our shield. He protects us wherever we go. Let's say this is us. This stick, we are like this stick, and we try to stand on earth by ourselves. We try to stand by ourselves by learning, by getting all the knowledge, by getting a fortune, and then do something. We try to stand, but we cannot. We cannot stand in this world by ourselves. We try, but when sickness comes, we just fall down. When we lose our jobs, we fall down hard. When relationship is broken, we fall down again. There's only way we can stand in this world is someone grab us and put on us. That is God. We may still waving, but we're not going to fall down again because God, Almighty God, holding us so we can stand. The Lord said in Isaiah 41, I am the Lord your God, who take hold of your righteous hand and says to you, do not fear, I will help you. God is with us. God is with you. He walks with you. He drives with you. He is with you. Wherever you go, the Lord is right there with you. So we give thanks to the Lord. God is the only fact that we are breathing at this moment should be enough to give thanks to the Lord. After David, introducing all the benefits, he said at the end of verse 5, so that your youth is renewed like the eagles. David was old when he wrote this psalm. I don't think he expected to become a 40-year-old man, young man. But he meant a spiritual renewal. As we praise God for the benefit we received, as we give thanks to God for all the blessings we have received, we will be renewed in our spirit every day. What a blessing is it? We already received the blessing. And as we just give thanks to God for the blessings we have received, there is more blessing coming to us. We will be renewed every day in our spirit. Our attitude about the blessings, our attitude about the benefit will determine our happiness. Happy life is not about getting what we want, but happy life is about living with what we have. We already have enough. And we just need to live with those blessings. As you know, song is not a song until you sing. Likewise, blessing is not blessing until we give thanks to God for it. People in this world waste their lives, spend all their lives concentrating on what they don't have. But we are to be different because we are forgiven and God is with us. We are forgiven and we have eternal life. And God is with us, He's protecting us every day, He's blessing us every day in our needs. So we should be different. Like David confessed, we need to praise God. We need to remember all the benefit we received. We need to give thanks to the Lord for the blessings we have received. Brothers and sisters, this week is Thanksgiving week. We'll have a Thanksgiving. This is Thanksgiving Sunday, and we'll have a Thanksgiving day. But not just this week, because God is not just blessing only in this week. So let us praise the Lord all year long, all of our lives. Let us give thanks to God with our soul, with all of our inmost beings. Yes, thank you, Lord. Let's pray. Father, we thank you again for your blessings. You forgave our sins by sending Jesus Christ, your own one and only Son. Not only spiritual blessings, but also you blessed us in every day in our lives. help us, we always give thanks.